Number one, your sitting distance from the dashboard. The distance that you are from the dashboard should be positioned such that the knees are slightly bent, even when depressing the brakes fully. Because in event of a frontal collision, bended knees would cushion the impact, thus saving your legs. If you are seated too far back, your knees would lock up when you do an e-brake. In the event of a frontal collision, your joints would get all the impact and they would have a very high chance of breaking. Number two, the inclination of your seat would determine how far your body would be from the steering wheel, and that would affect your arm position. If your elbows are locked, your arms would literally be limited when you try to avoid an accident. Not only will you not be able to move fast enough to steer away from danger, in the event of a collision, like the locked knees, the impact will likely cause injuries to your elbows and shoulders. So the ideal position would be for your arms to be bent and in a relaxed position. You will be able to steer freely and your arms would not obstruct each other when you try to do an evasive maneuver. So a good way would be, with your shoulders against the back of the seat, adjust it to a point where your wrist can hang comfortably over the steering wheel. Number three, the height of the steering wheel. Using your wrist as an initial guide, adjust the height of the steering wheel to a point where the cockpit is clearly visible. After that, our hands should be placed at the 3 and 9 o'clock position. This allows us to have a maximum range of motion when turning the wheel. Number four, the height of the headrest. Many people have the impression that the headrest is for us to, well, rest our heads and relax when we drive. Yes, that's true. But the actual function of the headrest is actually to protect our necks from whiplash if our car gets hit from behind. When we suffer a rear impact, our heads would snap backwards forcefully. If there is nothing to stop that sudden movement, we risk serious injuries to our neck. So the way to set it would be to adjust the height of your headrest until it is in line with the top of your head. In that way, it would deploy and cushion your head in the event of a rear collision. I believe no matter what kind of driver you are, this video can help all of us become safer drivers.